Before we get into sweeping or importing, let's look at what private keys are. Here I have created a brand new, never been used wallet. I have removed the encryption just to save time entering passwords as we explore. Don't do this at home. If I open up its properties, we can see there are no addresses in this wallet. To generate an address, click on Receive Bitcoins. This would be an address used to have someone send you Bitcoins. If they send them to you, the Bitcoins would be associated with this address. Clicking Done, we can see this in the address list now. Double-clicking this, we see the details and also view the keys associated with this address. Each address has a private key, highlighted here. The private key allows you to be able to spend the Bitcoins associated with this address. Before we move on, let's look at a watching-only wallet. This one here will do. It has a number of addresses, and if we have a look at one of them, and also view the keys, what do you notice? There is no private key, because for a watching-only wallet, you need to have the full or offline wallet do the signing as it has the private keys. Okay, so here's the fun part. If you have the private key, you are able to generate the rest, and hence not only see what coins are at an address, but spend those as well. If you import a private key into a wallet, you bring the coins and you can spend them. You are also going to receive any future coins sent to that address. The downside is if you place any coins at that address, someone who also has the private key can access those coins. That brings us to sweeping. This is just the process of moving bitcoins from one address to another. Sweeping coins from a private key places them in your wallet at an address only known by you, so protected. Sweeping or importing private keys is something you can do from the wallet properties. It is initiated by clicking on this link. When you do, you will see a warning message. First, imported private keys are not automatically backed up, and second, the recommendation is to sweep if you are not going to use the private key, as it is more secure. Click OK. If you have a single key for a single address, you can place it here. If you have multiple keys, then select this option, and then paste the key information here. I have a single key that I copied, so I will go back to this option and paste this key. Now what I will do first is the recommended sweep, so I will leave this checked. We can see that this key is associated with this address. I can tell you it is correct for the moment, so I will click Yes. And now this message tells me what is about to happen. Funds will be transferred from, as it turns out, a wallet that I am in control of, into this new wallet. That's what sweeping does, transfers the funds, which is nice and secure. However, let's not do this and see what happens if we import the key instead. To import keys, I need to go to a different armory because you can't import a key from one wallet to another in the same armory. So let's go to a different one now. Here we have another empty wallet. I will open up the properties and click on the Import Sweep Private Keys. I can paste that private key in here and then select Import rather than Sweep. When I click on OK, I get that message about the address again. Accepting this, the key has been imported, and once the blockchain has been scanned, I will be able to look at the balance. Here is the balance, which was the amount in the original address. Moving over to the other armory, where that wallet and address existed before, I can see that the funds have not moved. They are accessible from both locations. As a result, sweeping is recommended so that someone else who might have that key cannot control them anymore.